Welcome to this series of lectures on microcontrollers. We will be talking about the 8051 core architecture. 8051 core architecture was proposed by Intel, and microcontrollers were manufactured based on this architecture by Intel, followed by many other companies. This is one of the most popular architecture in the world of microcontrollers. The features of a computer are best learned by studying the hardware design, that is the internal hardware design of the machine, and this is known as the architecture of the machine. So we are here interested in talking about the 8051 architecture. So we'll be trying to understand the internal hardware design of 8051. So let us begin with the 8051 core as proposed by Intel. We can see that here we have the basic idea of the arithmetic logic unit of the core. Here it is proposed that there should be an internal ROM, read-only memory. This is 4 kilobytes. Then there is an internal RAM of 128 bytes. These are various special function registers which we will talk about. They are popularly called as SFR, and as we introduce various components of this architecture, we will be talking about the SFR related with that components. Now this is an important part of the microcontroller which interface with the world, and that is the ports. It has got four ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3, each of them having 8 bits. So you have 32 port pins on the 8051 microcontroller. This is the port area from where it interfaces with the external world. And then here we have got the timing and control unit. So let us see how we can further understand this core. Here is a picture which shows that what type of memory is present inside the system. As we have said, this is the 4 kilobyte of internal read-only memory, ROM. Nowadays this is replaced by 4 kilobyte of flash memory, which can be programmed with very simple 5 volt serial programmers. The series of that microcontrollers are called 89S51. The starting address is 000 and the last address in the 4 kilobyte block is FFF. There are certain versions of this core, higher versions, which accommodate 8 kilobytes and more memory. That will be discussed at a later stage. Generally here we will write down our program. This block over here shows the RAM area of our 8051. It is organized as 128 bytes of RAM, starting with address 00 going up to F7. Apart from that, we have the special function registers, the data pointer, the program counter. It is once again a 16-bit register. These are the latch related with the ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. Now here we have two main registers. One is the register A, that is generally a part of arithmetic logic operation, and the other is register B. 8051 supports many mathematical operations which use the register A and register B. So this explains the memory organization of 8051. The most interesting feature to be noted over here is that the program memory has a separate address space as compared to the data memory. The address space of the data and program are separate. So now we go ahead with the discussion of the 128 bytes of RAM present inside the system. These 128 bytes are distributed into three different parts which do different type of functions. The first block is called the register banks. The second block is called the bit addressable RAM or bit addressable registers, and the third block is the general purpose registers. 8051 has got four different register banks, each containing eight registers. This register bank is selectable under program control. The second block is the bit addressable RAM. The bit addressable RAM is a block of memory which contains 128 bits organized as 16 bit addressable registers. Each bit can be addressed individually. And the third block is the block of general purpose registers. It comes down to 18 values. These general purpose RAM area can be used for storing your data and stack operations. Let us try to understand it in more details. The first block is shown over here. So 8051 register banks have four register banks. Each bank has eight registers, namely R0, R1, R2, R3 up to R7. So this is one register bank which has eight registers, and that is called the bank 0. So the bank 0 starts from address 00 and goes up to 07. The 00 address, the byte at 00 address is called the R0 register. The byte at 01 address is called the R1 register. At 02 address is called the R2 register, and so on. 07 is the R7 register. All of these belong to the bank 0. We can use one bank at a time in a program. That means we cannot use all the banks simultaneously. You can use one bank at a time, and the bank which is selected will decide to which register we are talking. So similarly, in bank 1 we have 8 registers, R0, R1, R2, R3 and so on. But now here the RAM addresses are different. The R0 register is located at 08 in bank 1, which was at 00 in bank 0, and 10 in bank 2 and 18 in bank 3. Similarly, we will have R1, whose address is 01, 09, 11 and 19. R2 will have address 02, 0A, 12 and 1A, and so on. The registers R0 to R7 will be addressed depending on the bank you are selecting. Now the selection of bank is done with two bits present in a special function register called PSW. PSW is a special function register which has two bits whose names are RS0 and RS1. So if the programmer puts the value of these two bits as 00, then the programmer is talking with bank 0. If you write 01 in these two bits, that means RS is equal to 0, RS0 is 0 and RS1 is 1, then you are talking to bank 1. If RS0 is 1 and RS1 is 0, you are talking to bank 2. And if RS1 is 1 and RS0 is also 1, you are talking to bank 3. So depending on the values selected for RS0 and RS1 in PSW register, the banks are selected. Whenever you restart your system, these two values are made 0. That means whenever you restart, you are talking to bank 0. So to summarize the banks, there are four banks selectable with these two bits RS0 and RS1 in PSW register, and the banks can be switched by the programmer by changing the value of these bits. So now it is in the hands of the programmer to efficiently use this facility. Next, we have the remaining area of the memory, which is organized as 16-bit addressable registers, right? These are 16-bit addressable registers. Each bit in this register can be addressed individually. That means you can either talk to the bit over here or to the bit over here or to the bit over here, while in this general purpose registers you have to talk to the whole byte. But when you put your data over here, then you can talk to these bits individually. So these bits can represent the status of various status as ones or zeros depending on the value which is intended by the programmer. So 16 registers, each having 8 bits, that comes out to 128 bits of bit addressable RAM. The starting address of the bit addressable RAM is 20 and the ending address is 2F. The bit 0 of 20 has an address 00. So the bit 0 of 20 has an address 00. The bit 1 of 20 has an address 01, and so on. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, F, right? And so on you go up to 7F. So from 00 to 7F, these are 128 bits which can be addressed independently. So it is bit addressable RAM. Apart from this, we have the last unit, and that is the general purpose RAM area. It is a group of 80 bytes which are general purpose RAMs, and they can be used for various operations like storing some data or storing some intermediate data or writing the stack and so on. So this brings us to the end of the first discussion of 8051 core architecture. Thank you for hearing this.